Good morning, students. I am Himlata Patil, your SS teacher. Welcomes you all for this video lecture. Students, in your SS, there is chapter number 5 and chapter number 17. We have explained it into 5 or 6 videos. But now it's time for your revision, for your help. I am coming here in a short discussion, a short information about these both chapters. So let's see. Just revise it. Okay. So see now, students. First, we are going to see our equatorial forest. Okay. So you know that what is equator? Okay. So let's see what is equator. Equator is an imaginary line. Okay. That makes two parts of hemisphere, okay, north hemisphere and southern hemisphere. This is a imaginary line. Okay, so let's see now. Here, see, this is imaginary line. Now we are going to see now, students, here. Now, this you come to know what is equator. Now, we are going to see what are the equatorial forests. See here, this is equator, imaginary line. So, from 0 to 10, and here also from south and north, both sides, 0 to 10 degree equator. Both here, what is this belt is called from here. Spread to here means it is little bit from here. Okay, so it will come our equatorial forest. Now, student, see here what is the green highlighter is there, that is our equatorial forest. So it is coming in which zone? You can see that it is near the equator, it is a torrid zone. Okay, so let's see. So now we will see next. Okay, here we are going to see next, that is location. What is exact location of that? See now, students, this is South America. Okay. So from south, this is Ecuador. Okay, we will take pen. Okay, this is Ecuador, Colombia and Brazil. Okay, it is from South America. Now let's move. This is West Africa. See here, it is very small one, but it is enhanced here. Now see here, Republic of Congo and Equatorial Guinea. Both are here equatorial forest. Now let's see next, Guinea coast. Now see here, Asia. So here see, this is the part of this India. Then afterwards Austria, okay, Singapore, Malaysia, okay, Malaysia, Indonesia. Okay, these parts are for this equatorial forest. If you want to see India, we can see here. See here, India, India's part. Okay, Austria's part, Congo, here, and this one. You can see this exactly. Now, let's move forward. That is, what is about climate? Now, as you know that it is in the torrid zone. So because of it is in the torrid zone, here high rate of evaporation from the large rivers, ponds, seas and transpirations from plants. And that's why here is too much heavy rainfall throughout the year. And its average of 250 and 350 centimeter annually. Okay, and you know that it is from the torrid zone, so it's hot, temperature is hot and humid. Okay, so now let's move forward for plant life. Here, healthy growth of plants are there, and that's why here always green, and these forests are always seems green, and because of that it's called evergreen forest region or heavy rainfall, that's why it's called a rainforest. And now, so because of that, why it's always green? Because these leaves are, trees are not shedding their leaves at the same time, and because of that every time it's looking very green, so it's called evergreen forest. And their leaves are always, how it's thick, okay, leaves are also thick and broad and thick, and that branches are also thick. So this is the main thing. And one thing, students, when it's a heavy rainfall, so that time accompanied by with the thunderstorm, so it is one characteristic of equatorial forest. Now we will see that these plants, have you seen this picture? These plants, you can see that they are mingled here, okay, dear. So it's like a umbrella, so it's called, it is, they are mingled with each other. Every layer you can see 10 centimeter also, shrubs are also there under canopy, some trees are here, then these trees, and then emergence. So these trees, canopy trees, are mingled with each other, and that's why it becomes very thick like a umbrella. And because of that, what happened? Sun rays are not coming or not reaching till the earth, and because of that here is dump. Okay, this area is dump because there is not any evaporation at the downside. Okay, now let's see plants life. So here we can see beautiful orchids, lianas climbers, creepers, these are climbers. But very important thing that their mahogany and ebony, these are very thick type and very valuable wood trees are there that provides woods, and their wood is very valuable because it can mold any shape. So that's why industries are using these mahogany and ebony wood. Understood, students? Now let's see next. That is, what is wildlife here? See here, because of dense forest, these what animals are feeling free there. Okay, so chimpanzees, monkeys, gorillas, jaguars, elephants, and okapis. It look like half like a zebra. Okay, so they are living very nicely there. Now some insects are there like anaconda, mosquitoes, spiders, crocodiles, butterflies, and very colorful birds. So this is very richest thing there. Okay, so now we'll see what is about this human life. Now actually here the atmosphere and the all the soil is very damp, dense, forests are very dense. Okay, and because of that it is not suitable to live there for human life. Okay, so Amazon basin, Zaira basin, island Philippines, there is not so much population, so because of dense and damp forest. And if there is not any sun rays are reaching to the soil, and that's why it feels dark also. Okay, so that's why there is yes. Now see, these are Bantu tribes in Zaira Basin and Javas and Kungus tribes. What are tribes? Tribes are the group of people. They are living in a group and they are just hunting and living their life in a jungle. Okay, so how they are living their life? They are doing agriculture. They have two type of agriculture, shifting agriculture and plantation agriculture. So what is shifting agriculture? These people are clearing enough piece of land enough properly, okay, and they are bowing some seeds and afterwards they are using their maize, rice and cassava. But after the 3-4 years, when they come to know that this is not fertile, so they are leaving that, they are shifting for the another piece of land. A plantation, they are using here for the purpose of this land, large scale of purpose. Why? For the merchant type. Okay, they are thinking that if we will grow here tea, coffee, rubber, cocoa, so we can sell it and we can earn money. So here is a one like this. See here. So these are these type of fields they are using, and they are using this. So this is one type of plantation. Okay. So and with the help of this, they are using commercial type of, they are using for that and they are earning money from that. So this is their agriculture. So you come to know, students, what is that? So this is all about the equatorial forest. So now I think you come to know what is that. The equatorial region falls in the torrid zone, okay, and lies on both sides of the equator, 0 to 10. The climate of the equatorial region is hot throughout year, and the duration of the days and night is equal there. Okay, a large variety of plants are found in the equatorial region. Trees in equatorial forest grow in several layers. Different type of layers are there. The tribes found in this dense forest practice food gathering, hunting, and shifting agriculture. Understood, students? This is all about the equatorial forest. Now let's move another topic, another lesson that is some people never done. It is all about our leaders, okay, Indian leaders who has served their lives, led their lives for our country. Okay, so one of them, who is she? She's Mother Teresa. So Mother Teresa born on 26th, okay, August 1910 in Skopje, Macedonia. Her real name was Agnes Gonza Bojakshu. Her mother's name was Drain Bojakshu. Her mother's father's name was Nicola. He was successful merchant. Now, when she was at the age of 12, she decided that I should do work for missionary and I should spread love of Christ. And for that, she left her home of age of 18, okay, and she joined Irish community of nuns with missions in India. There she received the name Sister Mary Teresa after Saint Teresa of Lisieux. Saint Teresa Lisieux, after she got this name, Sister Mary Teresa. Now we will see what Mother Teresa has done. So Mother Teresa spread sympathy, affection, compassion among the poor and needy person. Those are poor and needy person, she has spread there her love. She opened air school. Okay, she established so many charitable things. Open air school, auspices. Now what is auspices? Means the the hospitals which are caring for the physical and spiritual care. Okay, so spiritual hospitals, that's called hospices. And mobile clinics means they are moving, they can move from here to there. And this is treating leprosy. What is leprosy? Leprosy is a chronic curable infectious disease, mainly affects skin, eyes, nose and nerve damage. So she was just serving that people, those nobody was paying attention, for AIDS patients also. And homes for orphans means those have not parents or home. Okay, and those have homeless person, she has given them home. So she has not done work in the India only, like other countries, Tanzania, United States, Austria, Venezuela, and other countries also. So her work was not only for India, but all over, okay, all over world. Now, talking about her awards, they are, she got Indian Padma Shri Award in 1962, Nobel Peace Prize Award in 1979, Roman Magsaysay Award, then Pope John, 23rd Peace Prize Award in 1971, Nehru Prize Award in 1972, then Balzan Prize Award in 1978, Bharat Ratna Award in 1980. And she died on September 5th, 1997, when her 87th birthday, after that 9 days, she died. She was given the honor of state. So it's all about Mother Teresa. Now we are moving forward about Sonal Mansingh. Now see, Sonal Mansingh born on 1st May 1944. Sonal Mansingh's mother's name was Poonima, okay, and father's name was Arvind. Now, her mother was activist, okay? She was in also politics, she was social worker, and she got Padma Bhushan Award also. Her grandfather, he was a freedom fighter and first five governors of India. So, this political background she got, okay? So now, we'll see about her. She was classical dancer, specializes in Bharatanatyam and Odissi. It was the foremost one, but not only she has stopped there. She was expert in Manipuri dance also and Kuchipudi dance also. She was not only dancer, okay? She was not only dancer, but she was choreographer. Choreographer means who is guiding to dance, okay? Then teacher, orator, and social activist to welfare people. And now let's see her career. She has established Center for Indian Classical Dances, that means CICD, in New Delhi for guidance for the people. So this is the most achievement of her. She has done the choreographer of Indraprastha, Manavata, Savras, Devi Durga, Atmayan, Mera Bharat, and Drupadi. These are the dramas she has choreographed for that. Now let's see her awards. We are talking about her award. So she Sangeet Natak Academy Award in 1987. Then Rajiv Gandhi Excellence Award in 1991. See here, Sangeet Natak Academy Award and Rajiv Gandhi Excellence Award. Now let's see Padma Bhushan in 1992, Padma Vibhushan in 2003, Kalidas Saman in 2006. Okay, honored with Kalidas Saman by the government of Madhya Pradesh. Okay, So she got lots of awards. Now, this was all about Sonal Mansi. Now, let's see about our missile man. Okay, who is that person? You can see that. Okay, so he is none of them, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So his full name was Aul Pakir Chainulabdin Abdul Kalam. Okay, so students, now we'll see this Rameshwaram. This is his birthplace. Okay, this is his house. Okay, now it becomes a library now. Okay, it became library. What about his early life? His father, okay, Jainulabdin, he was boat owner and imam of local mosque. And his mother, Ashi Amma, she was housewife. And here is our Abdul Kalam ji. Okay, now let's see. He has graduated, then afterwards he went in 1955 to study aerospace engineering in Madras Institute of Technology. See here. Now let's see. He was not only scientist, not only engineer, not only professor, not only an author, not only president. He was all things were included in one man, that is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Now let's see our projects, what he has done projects. He has done 5 projects within a 10 years, that is Nag, Prithvi, Akash, Trishur and Agni. Okay, see here, Agni. Now let's see, here SLV-3 means satellite launch vehicle. Then here is this Prithvi and here also Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV. So that's why he has been called Missile Man, because he has made so many missiles. He has written so many books, but favorite books are Wings of Fire, okay, Ignited Minds, India's 2020, Visions for the New Millennium. Then these all books he has written. These books are worth reading. So read that books. Now about the awards. Number of awards. See here. Number of awards he got. But I am taking only few. Okay. Receiving Bharat Ratna Award. Okay. Here Engineering Award. Doctor of Engineering. Here is over medal. Okay. These awards he is getting. Now, Government of India has honored him with the Padma Bhushan in 1981 and Padma Vibhushan in 1990 for his work with ISRO and DRDO. Now, let's move. On 27th July 2015, what happened when she was delivering his lecture? The students at that time addressing the IIM students at Shillong, he got a heart attack and he fell down. And this, our missile man has died. So this is all about our APJ Abdul Kalam. He got honored there. Okay, now we are moving forward about the Amartya Sen. Now, this Amartya Sen, who is that great person? He is a economist. What is economist? Economist is an expert who studies about the economy. Okay, study about how money will put to use by different people in the society for various goods and service. Now let's see Amartya Sen. a medicine is born. Where? In the Shantiniketan. You know where is Shantiniketan? Shantiniketan is in West Bengal, India. Okay, his mother name was Amita and father's name is Ashutosh. Okay, he is born 3rd November 1933. So this Rabindranath Tagore has given his name Amartya Sen. What a beautiful name, Amartya Sen. Now, he has graduated in 1953. Okay, then again he has graduated another subject, that is 1955. First he has done BA in economics, then another subject in 1955. And MA he has done in 1959. And same time he has submitted his PhD also, and he became doctor. Okay. He has worked in 1961 to 72 in Delhi School of Economics. Okay. And he was professor there. Then at the London School of Economics also he was professor there. He has also taught University of Calcutta. Then Harvard University also. Now, currently he is professor there, economics and philosophy. He is a professor there, okay, and he is doing his work there. The University of Oxford, he is there. He has written so many books, but one is Development as Freedom, The Idea of Justice. These are the main books, okay, that we should read that. We will see awards. He has won Bharat Ratna Award. This is most civilian award. And he is the 6th Indian to receive Nobel Prize in Economics and 1st Asian to receive Economics Prize. See here, Bharat Ratna. Okay, let's see. Nobel Prize. This is Nobel Prize. Okay. Medal here. Okay, let's move. So, students, this was all about these great, great leaders. And it was short because of time. So, students, you have to think about it. Okay, learn it and practice it. Okay, so this is all about all the leaders. All the best. And thank you, all of you. Okay.